Vijay Kevlani, Assistant Professor, LG Institute of Pharmacy. Welcome to a MOOC series, an initiative taken by LG Institute of Pharmacy. In today's session, we are going to talk about anemia. So, anemia is a condition when there is low amount of hemoglobin in our body. So, whenever the amount of hemoglobin is less than normal limit, it is known as anemia. Now remember that it is not about number of RBCs, it is about hemoglobin present in our body. So normal range of hemoglobin is 14 mg per dl, so it should be above 14 mg per dl for male, and it should be above 12 mg per dl for female. If there is any change or if the amount of hemoglobin is less than that, so that condition is known as anemia. Now, based on the reason, anemia can be classified into microcytic, macrocytic and normocytic. In microcytic anemia, the amount, the size of RBC is less, or decreased size of RBC is seen. In macrocytic anemia, the RBCs are large, and in normocytic anemia, the RBC size is normal, but still the amount of hemoglobin is less. So let's see that definition. So anemia, N means without and hema means blood. So anemia is condition where there is less amount of hemoglobin. So anemia is a decrease in the RBC count, hemoglobin and or hematocrit value, resulting in lower ability for the blood to carry oxygen to body tissues. Pathophysiology. So we already know what happens whenever the amount of hemoglobin is not synthesized. Okay, our body is not able to cope up with the regular requirement of hemoglobin, or if sufficient amount of iron or vitamin B12 are not present in our body, it will lead to decrease the formation of hemoglobin and by that decreased number of RBC. So here is image, simple, explaining the role of hemoglobin in our body. So hemoglobin is utilized for ultimately carrying oxygen and delivering to the cells of our body. So this is explained the role of erythropoietin. So whenever hypoxia is felt in kidney, kidney will release erythropoietin. This erythropoietin will reach to bone marrow where hemoglobin synthesis occurs, and this erythropoietin will speed up the reaction and increase the production of RBC. Now there will be a condition when sufficient amount of factors like iron, vitamin B12, vitamin B6, folic acid, riboflavin or copper are not available in sufficient quantity, and that will lead to impairment of erythropoiesis or hemoglobin synthesis, and finally it will lead to iron deficiency, or it will lead to anemia. So decrease in RBC, HB or hematocrit level, that will lead to diminished oxygen carrying capacity, which produces hypoxia and hypoxia induced effect on organ function. And finally, anemia is observed. The sign and symptoms of anemia are observed. Normal values, we have already discussed this normal value of hemoglobin in different ages. Classification of anemia. So anemia can be classified based on cause and based on morphology of RBC. Based on cause, it can be due to blood loss, inadequate production of normal blood cells, or excessive destruction of blood cells. And based on morphology, it can be classified into normocytic, macrocytic and microcytic. Types of anemia based on clinical picture. So it could be iron deficiency, megaloblastic, pernicious anemia, hemorrhagic anemia, hemolytic anemia, thalassemia and sickle cell anemia, and aplastic anemia. So in iron deficiency anemia, what happens? There is excessive loss of iron, or sufficient amount of iron is not present in our body, and that condition indicates iron deficiency anemia. It is a kind of microcytic anemia. Next is megaloblastic anemia, which is due to deficiency of vitamin B12 and vitamin B9. That is folic acid, and next is cyanocobalamin. So due to deficiency of these two are maturation factor of RBC. If sufficient amount of B12 and B9 is not present, The RBC will not mature, and ultimately immature cell will destruct fast and lead to anemic condition. Pernicious anemia. So it is related to, once again, B12 deficiency, and this occurs due to the inappropriate or body is unable to absorb vitamin B12. Why body is unable to absorb vitamin B12? The reason behind that is body is not able to produce intrinsic factor which is required for absorption of vitamin B12. Types of anemia. So very first is normochromic normocytic, means the hemoglobin is normal in RBC, the size of RBC is normal, but the amount of hemoglobin and amount of RBC is decreased. That condition is known as normochromic normocytic anemia. Next is hypochromic microcytic anemia. When size of RBC is less than the normal size, that condition is known as microcytic anemia. Now, in microcytic anemia occurs due to specifically iron deficiency, and thalassemia is also a type of microcytic anemia. Next is normochromic macrocytic anemia. So in macrocytic anemia, the size of RBC is larger than normal. Now, this large size RBC are immature in nature, and this occurs due to deficiency of vitamin B12 and vitamin B9. So this is hyperchromic, normochromic and hypochromic, and on the x-axis you can see macrocytic, normocytic and microcytic anemia. These are RBC cells, right? Risk factor. So due to poor socioeconomic class, multiparity, teenage pregnancy and menstrual problem, anemia may occur. Causes. So increased requirement during menstrual females, menstruating female, pregnancy, lactation, growing infants and children, and erythropoietin treatment. Next is increased loss during GI bleeding, menorrhea, persistent hematuria, intravascular hemolytic anemia, regular blood donors and parasitic infections. Decreased intake. So vegetarian diet and socioeconomic factors lead to decreased intake of iron and sufficient vitamin B12 and decreased absorption. So upper GI pathology or gastrectomy or medication will lead to decreased GI absorption. So this all condition may lead to loss of RBC or decreased amount of iron and B12, and ultimately lead to different type of anemia. Sign and symptoms. So easy fatigue and loss of energy, unusually rapid heartburn, particularly with exercise, shortness of breath and headache, particularly with exercise, difficulty in concentrating, dizziness, pale skin, leg cramps and insomnia, brittle nails, coiloning chia, that is spoon shaped nails. Signs of anemia. So brittle nails, signs of anemia. So brittle nails, coiloncia, atrophy of papillae of tongue, angular stomatitis, brittle hair, dysphagia and glossitis, and plumber vision or Kelly patterns. Investigation. So the red cell population is defined by quantitative parameters: volume of packed cell, that is hematocrit, hemoglobin concentration, red cell concentration per unit volume. Qualitative parameters include MCV, that is mean corpuscular volume, mean corpuscular hemoglobin, mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration. So these are the normal range of all the parameters. Frequently asked question from this topic are: references. Thank you. Please like, share and subscribe our channel PharmaIgnite for more updates.